Hello guys, welcome to my YouTube channel. In this video I am discussing about the observer design pattern. Observer design pattern and shape. Observer design pattern is a design pattern. It falls under the behavior design category of the design pattern. Observer design pattern has implemented where we need to implement one-to-many relationship of an object, where one object states have been changed and other objects get notified about their state and update accordingly. For example, we have one object and other are hundreds of thousands of objects are associated with these objects, and if one object's state or any property has been changed, then our other object will get notified about their change and perform accordingly. We have example where we have one decimal in number system. We have one decimal, that is 10. If we change 10 to 11, then all the other classes, all the other objects, that is octal, binary, hexadecimal, are updated accordingly. So this is observer design pattern. Another example of observer design pattern is that group chat application. This is the best example. In group chat application, hundreds of members are added into group, and if one of the members send a message in the group, then other members will receive the notification and update about the group chat conversation. So this is the observer design pattern, where one person send a message and all other person will get notified about their message and update their chat conversation accordingly. So this is a one-to-many relationship of an observer design pattern. So we have an example of observer design pattern in C#. How to implement observer design pattern, how to perform and practically, we have one interface, I subject. This subject this is a subject where one subject that is implement I subject interface that has been, which states has been changed, and one state has been changed, then this subject object will notify all other observer objects accordingly. So we have one interface, that is subject, and one method attach, where all the objects are attached to this subject. Means we have a hundred of thousand of object. If we want to attach to one single subject, if we have one subject and thousand of observer object has been attached by this. So this is a attach function where object is attached to this subject. And notify function is the function that is notify about their change. Subject property has been changed, then call notify object to update all the observer method accordingly. So this is our observer interface where update function has been called. This is an object. This is an observer, that is observe the changes about the subject. Now the implementation of I subject interface. We have a Vitter station, and Vitter station have a list of observers. This is a list of observer where all the objects are associated with this. And Vitter station have a temperature. We have a temperature where we return the temperature, and we set the temperature, means the temperature value has been changed, and then immediately call the notify method. This is the observer design pattern main functionality, where if temperature has been changed over Vitter station, then notify method call immediately to tell the other objects that temperature has been changed accordingly and perform accordingly. And this is our constructor, and this is our attach method, where we register our observer in this attach in this subject, that is registered, and notify method that is use all the observer to notify about the changes, that is called in this function. If temperature has been changed, then this will call notify method. Notify method will look through for each observer and call the update method, that is temperature has been changed, and perform their function accordingly. So this is our subject, where Vitter station how to bridge has been changed, then it will call rotary method immediately to perform the function of an observer or observer. And other thing is that I observed news agency, where news agency listen to the weather station. If temperature has been changed, then it will call rotary method, and rotary method will call update method of the news agency or the news agency. Where if temperature one has been changed in weather station, then all other hundreds of news agency get about their changes of the temperature. For example, we have a weather station and we have a news agency A, news agency B, and news agency C. If temperature weather station showing their temperature 1, then all three news agency will show report their temperature into 1. If news weather station temperature has been changed to 2, then it will call notify method, and notify method will update the all the news agency to be report the updated temperature accordingly. So this is our news agency agency name, and this is update method. It will call the for each method update method, then it will show the temperature has been changed. So this is our observer design pattern. If you, in implementation we have a weather station, we have a news agency 1, then we attach news agency to the weather station, then we have news agency 2, then we attach news agency 2 to the weather station, then we change the temperature, then second we change the temperature, then now see what's happened. So that is. So we have two news agency that is registered to the weather station. When weather station temperature 1 has been changed 1.1, then A news agency and B news agency will update their temperature. And when we change 1.2 temperature, then A news agency and B news agency will update their temperature and show that their temperature has been updated. So this is the observer design pattern. This is a best example of observer design pattern, where one to many relationship has been implemented. One relationship of weather station and many relationship of news agency, where weather station change their temperature and update all the news agencies to be for the updated temperature. This is happened to be by using multiply method, and all news agency registered to this attach function. So this is the syntax of how to implement an I or observable interface in C sharp. I hope you are understand about this. Please subscribe to my channel by comment if you have any questions.